Chris, and thanks so much for watching. Today's video is going to be my list of myths that people have about buying high-end sunglasses, and I'm going to try to disprove all of those. People usually have a common arguments that they come up with when you talk about the fact that you have a nicer pair of sunglasses, they think it's a waste of money, and they usually follow that up with either one of these four reasons. So I want to just kind of talk to you a little bit about that today, why I think they're wrong and why I think I'm right. And usually I'm not that confident in myself, so here we go. Okay, so there's several arguments that people come up with. The first argument is that you're going to lose them. People are always like, why don't you spend that much money on a pair of sunglasses, you're just going to lose them. Okay, first of all, the people usually that lose them are the ones that like take them on vacation and don't keep up with them. Either that, they have them in their main luggage and it gets lost somewhere, or they are just kind of careless with where they sit it. You know, they're not keeping up with it, and then in that case it's just kind of like you could have looked after it a little bit. I will say that the price of high-end sunglasses has a lot to do with it. If you care how much that you invested in that, you look at it as an investment, then you take better care of it. It's like getting something like a new washer or dryer, or a new dishwasher, or a new car. You're really picky about who drives it, what they do with it, and slapping everybody's wrist who even tries to touch it. So it's the same way with sunglasses. If you care enough about it, you're gonna look after it. If you're going away, then I would suggest don't take your whole designer collection to go to Italy because you want to look stunning every day of the week, you know, because you're gonna at least lose one pair. So I would just suggest to take one of your higher end pairs with you, should you decide to get one, and keep it in your hand luggage or your carry-on bag, and always keep it in its case. That's my like rule of thumb, because when it's in the case, you minimize a lot of these bad things happening to your sunglasses. Also, for the love of God, don't wear them like out on the water. Like, there's no reason you should be like on a speedboat with $300 Gucci's on. My uncle went to Sunglass Hut and bought his first pair and only pair of Ray-Ban aviators, and then went to a local lake and lost them in the lake, and then he proceeded to be mad at the fact that he lost his sunglasses. He wasn't mad at himself, he was mad at the fact that the sunglasses like leapt off his head and got lost in the water. So just be smart about it and you're not going to lose them. I think you'll be surprised with yourself. A second point is people think they're going to break them. Now, higher end sunglasses are designed superiorly anyway to be extra tough and have extra durable frames and lenses, so it's going to take a lot more to break them. Now, it's kind of like the way an iPhone or a Samsung Galaxy is, wherein you get a few grace falls. If you drop them a few times, they're not going to be completely broken, but you are going to get some scratches here and there. That's what an OtterBox is for. Similarly, that's what a sunglass case is for. I find that when I take them off of my face and put them into their case and in my purse or a safe place, instead of leaving them on my head, there's a lot less risk of them getting broken. They're going to take a lot, but as long as you put them in the case, you're going to be fine. People who say they sit on their sunglasses, I'm not really sure what goes on with that. Unless they're in your back pocket, I can see that being accidental, but are they just under you in crevices in your couch and you're sitting on them? Are they in your driver's seat all the time and crunch, you sat on them again? I didn't really get how you keep sitting on your sunglasses. But again, if they're in their hard shell case, which most nice sunglasses come with, then even if you sit on them, they're pretty much going to be fine. Now, the third thing is, nice sunglasses, high-end sunglasses, a lot of times have warranties. There are brands that have lifetime warranties. Some brands such as Costa, Spy Optics, and Smith have lifetime warranties for manufacturer's defects. And if the company itself doesn't have a warranty, then you can go to a site like Smart Buy Glasses that has a 2-year warranty on all their glasses, and designer like Versace, Dior, Valentino, D&G. Or you can go to a place like Sunglass Hut that's an in-store place that has warranties. The last thing is, they say they're just a piece of plastic. They're not just a piece of plastic. They're usually a piece of high quality acetate. Now, for your comparison viewing pleasure, I have brought 2 pairs of sunglasses. This is a cheap pair, and then I brought a pair of velvet eyewear sunglasses. The cheap pair, if you will, this is a knockoff of some D-squared sunglasses. The model, the real D-squared model is called the Lou, or the 0134 of D-squared, the Canadian brand. But if you look at these glasses, it's what I call hollow plastic. It makes this noise as you fold them up. It's just very, very cheap. Hinges are cheap. The metal pieces are just decorative. They could come unhinged at any minute. Oftentimes, if you have any dots on the side or anything decorative, they're not real rivets and they're not screwed in. They're just glued on. They're going to fall off. Lenses can pop out willy-nilly. It's just you get what you pay for. If you get a pair of designer sunglasses, they have a different sound when they open and close. It is, they're usually made from cellulose acetate, otherwise known as Zyl, and they came out with that around the 1940s, don't quote me on that, when cheaper glasses, they noticed the cheaper plastics were not holding up. So they came out with, started using cellulose acetate for sunglasses, and it not only proves lightweight but extremely durable. If I bend these frames a little bit, I hear no give, no crunching, no cracking. Those lenses are in there good. You pay, you get what you pay for again. Also, lenses on these are CR39 or European Zeiss lenses. You're getting a high optics quality here when you pay for a higher end pair of sunglasses. Also, again, I was talking about the case. You get a cleaning cloth to take really good care of them, and you get a really good hard shell case. It just seems indestructible. So when you've got these things to equip you, you can have a pair of designer sunglasses that last your whole lifetime if you just take care of them. So I really hope this video helped you. Maybe these common things that people mock you about when you like to buy nice sunglasses, you can share this with them. Feel free to pass it along. You know, because people carry nice handbags and wear nice clothes, and if it's not too much money to spend on a designer handbag, then why is it too much money to spend on a nice pair of sunglasses? So as long as you look at it as an investment, take care of your things and take pride in your things, no one's to tell you that it's a waste of money. So anyway, thanks so much for watching. Let me know what you think down below, and I'll see you next time.